Right. So now let's see how to download Jenkins. So in generally, at your workplace, you will have servers where you will host Jenkins on that particular server. Okay, basically DevOps guys will do that work for you. You need not worry about Jenkins installation and all. Your company will already having this. Okay, but we don't have any servers to host. So let's run this Jenkins in our local Windows machine. Okay, so that's why you will see URL like this, localhost. But in real time, when you are working in your company, you will see some company.com. Okay, so let's go and download Jenkins. Yeah, click on this download Jenkins and if you come down, you see here it's like war, right? Download this one, not any Windows or Ubuntu. Because as I said, we are using this Jenkins as Windows service. We are not hosting on any servers. So if you download this, it will just a .war file, which I already have in my machine. So it's just a war file. One single war file will get downloaded. So once it get downloaded, you can go back to your command prompt and can start your. Okay, so let me shut down the existing Jenkins what I am having right now. So it's not just exe file to start. Basically, you need to give one command to start this Jenkins server into your Windows machine. So the command is java jar. And what is the jar? So first you need to go to the path where exactly your Jenkins.war is located. Okay, if it is in your downloads, so navigate to the downloads path and then hit a command. So right now in my machine, it is in work folder. So that's why I am at work folder, and then I'll give my command java-jar jenkins.war. Okay, so basically we were asking to execute this war file. For that, this is the command. So first you need to tell that is a Java and jar what you are executing. It's nothing but jenkins.war and at what port you want to start this Jenkins server. Okay, in our local machine, you can generally start at 8080, but you might get this kind of error when you want to start it in 8080. If 8080 is already in use by other instance in your machine, then you will get an error saying 8080 port is already bind to another process. You cannot use that. Okay, so better to go with another port 9090. So that works, because in my machine 8080 is occupied with another process, I guess. So that's why I always start in 1990. It's up to you. Okay, so hit an enter and that will slowly take few seconds, and then you will see a log saying that Jenkins is up and running on 1990 port. Okay, this is the command you need to remember. Alright, so hit the enter. You see that? You'll see something logs like this. So it's trying to initialize the Jenkins on the 1990 port, and it says started initialization, started plugins, and it is preparing some plugins, and it's loading the jobs. And finally you will see a message like this: Jenkins is fully up and running. So if you have given 1990 port to start, you can simply hit this URL localhost 1990. Okay, after seeing that message, come here and hit an enter. You will be navigated to this page. Okay, for the first time you will be asked to create credentials. However, you will be having some kind of window asking, prompting you to provide the credentials. Okay, so once you give that, you will successfully log in into your Jenkins homepage. So this is the first step you need to do. So I'll write the command here so that you remember. So, but for practice purpose, I am showing you this Jenkins, but in real time, you need not worry about this installation part. You will already have in your company wherever you go. So that's a headache of DevOps guys or any architectural guys. Okay, so we have successfully completed our Jenkins installation, and we also seen the importance of Jenkins in the previous lecture. Now, firstly, we have to tell our Jenkins where exactly our softwares are lying. Now, the framework what you have developed in the previous lecture, if you go back and see, so here, what are the softwares you need? You need Maven. You need Java, and that's all. Okay, but don't confuse that. You might think I need Selenium or REST API or TestNG. So these all are part of pom.xml only. So once you give this Maven project in the Jenkins, so pom.xml will take care of getting all those jars for you. Okay, just don't worry about jar files, which are already configured in pom.xml as dependencies. Okay, so I told you one feature, right? In the when I'm talking about Maven, you have a proper integration with CI tool called Jenkins. Yeah, so Maven provides a proper integration to use all your projects which we developed into Jenkins. Okay, so Jenkins guys has provided plugins and proper command tools to provide all our Maven commands so that Jenkins accepts our Maven commands and run on behalf of us. Okay, just like command prompt, how we provided Maven commands, in Jenkins there are a provision to provide all these fields. So that's the reason Maven will really help a lot to integrate with CI tool called Jenkins. Okay, so yeah, so Maven and Java, these two we need, and we have to set up that for our Jenkins. Okay, so for that you have to go back and click on Manage Jenkins. Here, for the first time, you will not see any job here. Just don't worry. Okay, so let's create that job. But click on Manage Jenkins, and so here there is a link called Global Tool Configuration. Just click on this. So configure tools, their locations. If you see and read the description of this global tools. Yeah, it's like Maven and Java. Configure their locations, everything here. Okay, so by default, you would see something like this, JDK installations. So click on this. For practice purpose, now copy the path of Java JDK from your machine and provide it here. Okay, so initially you would see something like this. If you don't have any JDK installed for the first time when you come to this page, let me go again. Yeah, you would see like this JDK installations. So please click on this link and you will be prompted with Java home. So give the path which you have set in your system variables earlier for Java and the name of the Java. You see that this is the Java name, right? Provide this and just say okay, and that's all. And if you don't want to give anything, and if you want to bring automatically Jenkins to download the Java for you, you can simply check this checkbox. Okay, so that's the beauty of this tool. You need not give this tool and platform information. Select this checkbox and Jenkins will automatically install for you when you run the script. Okay, but better you provide this because you already have in the machine. Okay, so JDK is one, and next you will see something like this, Maven. Okay, add Maven or Maven installations. So click on this, and similarly, in the previous section, we have seen giving Maven home in our system variables. So copy that path and place it here, Maven home. Okay, now this page is like our system variables for our Windows. Okay, so if you want to execute these tests from our laptop or machine, we use the system variables in a Windows, right? So the Jenkins, if you want to run all your tests in Jenkins, and this configure tools is like system variables for Jenkins. So provide Maven home there, and also the name of the Maven, which is this one. Okay, and that's all. That's all you need to run the project. So Gradle and all these are not required. So Git is when you use source code, you will give the Git information, but for now you can just avoid that. So JDK and Maven, you can set these two configurations from this link, configure tools, and click on save. So that save your settings. Okay, so we are almost there to create a new job. Let me go back, and we have successfully configured our global setting. Next, I'll go back, and if I want to create a new job. So before creating new job, let's understand about a Jenkins workspace. Okay, so yep, we'll see that in our next lecture, and we'll take it from there. Thank you.